What is good, my fellow Chicago Bears fam? And on today's video, we have to talk about the Chicago Bears offensive line. Because I don't know about you guys, but I'm really, really concerned about the offensive line. And I'm really concerned what Andy Dalton will have to go through week one. Because if this offensive line is as injured as it is, Andy Dalton is going to have a really, really hard time week one. I don't know if he can score any points with our depleted offensive line. We only have two starters that are currently playing. Cody Whitehair, our left guard, and Sam Mustipher, our center. The rest are all injured. And on today's video, we are going to talk about what each offensive lineman is dealing with in terms of injuries. We're going to talk about how long they might be possibly out for. We're going to dive into possible tackles, guards that we can sign, and how we can make this happen in terms of moving contracts and trading a certain player. But before we dive into that, guys, I need your guys' help. If you guys could go and sack that like button for the YouTube algorithm, make sure you subscribe to my channel for the best and most unique Chicago Bears content. Make sure you watch this video all the way to the end so you know who are the possible offensive linemen, tackles, and the guards that we can sign and how we can make that happen. And make sure you hit bell notifications so you know whenever I post. But with that all being said, let's dive right into today's video. Now, the first injury we're going to talk about, and it's possibly the most concerning injury, is Tevin Jenkins. And Tevin Jenkins is currently dealing with back tightness. Next, we have Jermaine Afadi, who is dealing with a hip flexor. We have James Daniels, who is dealing with a quad injury. We have Larry Borum and Latavian Simmons, both on a concussion protocol. Now, let's dive into how long each player will be out for. I'm going to start out with Jermaine Afadi, our right guard. So Jermaine Afadi has a hip flexor, and a typical time for a minor tear in the hip flexor is 2 to 3 weeks. Now, significant ones can take up to 6 weeks, and severe ones can take up to 8 weeks to heal. So Jermaine Afadi might be close to return. Now, I don't really suspect that Jermaine Afadi has a severe hip flexor, because if that were to happen, he would be out for at least 8 weeks. And my thinking is, well, if he did have that, the Chicago Bears would most likely place him on IR, injured reserve. But the Chicago Bears did not do that. So I suspect that Jermaine Afadi might have a minor hip flexor or a severe hip flexor. Meaning if he has a minor hip flexor, he'll be coming back very soon. And if he has a significant hip flexor, he'll be back in another 2 to 3 weeks, depending on how long it takes him to recover. Now, next, let's talk about Tevin Jenkins. So when we're talking about Tevin Jenkins and his back injury, it's important for us to go back in time and look how Tevin Jenkins missed 3 games in college with a lumbar strain. And before we freak out, the Chicago Bears and other NFL teams did not see this as overly concerning. Also, in OTAs, Tevin Jenkins did not have any back issues. He was a full participant in rookie OTAs and a full participant in minicamp. So I don't really see this as a concern. Now with Tev, it's really, really hard to diagnose what his injury is, because we don't know much about his injury other than the fact he has back tightness. And Tev is quite possibly our most concerning injury. Again, our second round draft pick, a guy who we have high hopes for. Now, typically with a back tightness, it might take a player a couple of days or 3 to 4 weeks to fully recover from back tightness. Or it can be really, really severe and it can take months. So if Tev does have back tightness, it means he might be back this week or he might be back in another 2 weeks. Now, there is a chance that Matt Nagy and the Chicago Bears are not telling us the full story, and that Tevin Jenkins might be dealing with herniated disc, which would mean that Tevin Jenkins could not run, he cannot do any physical activities for a minimum of 4 to 6 weeks, which means it would take Tevin Jenkins at least until the season, a couple of weeks until after the season starts, really come back from his injury and to be that starting left tackle. But I don't suspect that Tevin Jenkins has a herniated disc, because if that were true, I fully believe that the Tevin Jenkins would be placed on IR. But the Chicago Bears didn't do that. They didn't even place him on the PUP list. So I think Tevin Jenkins is really, really close to returning. Also, if Tevin Jenkins did have a herniated disc, then why was he pushing a sled the other day? Adam Hodge and Adam Johns talked about how they saw Tevin Jenkins pulling a golf cart with some things on Chicago Bears training camp. And today, there was a video out on how Tevin Jenkins was on a stationary bike biking. So, I don't really think that if Tevin Jenkins had a serious back injury that he'd be allowed to do these things, that he'd be able to releasing. Now, most likely, I think that Tevin Jenkins might be dealing with a lower lumbar injury, which would sideline him for 3 to 4 weeks, meaning he can return like sometime next week, and he would probably miss our first preseason games against the Dolphins, but he will return against our game against the Bills, and that would be really cool to see Tevin Jenkins and Justin Fields play against you know who. So I think that we are freaking out with his injury, and Tevin Jenkins will be back soon, and we need to stop calling him a bust. We need to stop calling him the next Kevin White. This needs to stop. Now, next, let's dive into James Daniels. So James Daniels has a quad/thigh injury, and depending on his injury, it could sideline him for 3 weeks if he has a grade 1 thigh strain. Now, if he has a grade 2 thigh strain, it could sideline him for 4 to 6 weeks, and if he has a grade 3 sideline strain, it would require surgery, and he could be out for 3 months. But again, like Tevin Jenkins and Afadi, I don't think that he has a severe quad injury or a thigh injury. I think that if that were to happen, the Chicago Bears would have placed him on injured reserve right now, or at least a PUP list by now, and as of this video, they haven't done that. So I'm not too worried about James Daniels, and hopefully, like Tevin Jenkins, he can return sometime next week. Now let's talk about Larry Borum and Lechavion Sissons, who are in concussion protocol. Now the minimum time that a player has to serve in concussion protocol, one day or a few days, they have to pass a few tests to get out of concussion protocol. So hopefully both of those players will be back soon. Now, what if some of these injuries are more concerning? Like, what if we possibly see Tevin Jenkins getting placed on IR, or Jermaine Afadi getting placed on IR, or any of these other players? What are some of our free agent options? And there are a lot of good options currently on the free agent market. Now, the first option that many people want, including myself, is Russell Okung, who had a 73 PFF grade. And then we can sign former Packer, former Lion, Rick Wagner, who had a 77 PFF grade, or some more DeMar Doxson, who had a 70.8 PFF grade. And then there's also another option of Michael Schwartz, who is a former Chief. You know, he worked with Matt Nagy in the past, so maybe this is a guy that Chicago Bears bring in. And then in terms of a guard, like say James Daniels is out, you know, we could possibly sign former Steeler David DeCosto. And the only thing with David DeCosto is that I don't know if he wants to play football. There were some rumors coming out from Steelers camp, from Steelers media, that he didn't want to play football anymore, which is why he was released by the Steelers. And also, he has an ankle injury, so that may be concerning. But, you know, David DeCosto used to be one of the best guards in the NFL. So, you know, if James Daniels does have an injury, I would like to look at the Chicago Bears signing David DeCosto. And he might even be a better option than Alex Barr. So, how do we get enough money to sign a guy like Russell Okung or Rick Wagner or David DeCosto or some of the other options? Well, we have to currently discuss how much cap we currently have. Now, the Chicago Bears currently have about $6 million in cap room, and to sign some of these premier tackles like Russell Okung, Rick Wagner, you know, a guy like Michael Schwartz, I think they would have to pay at least $10 million a year towards. Now, to make this happen, we need to find an extra $4 million. How can we make this happen? What bright idea can we come up with? Well, we can trade Nick Foles, our third-string quarterback. I mean, there's no reason why Nick Foles should be on this team. I mean, Nick Foles is better than a third-string quarterback. And he should be traded to a team like the Jets, the Colts, you know, a team like the Broncos, a team like the Jags. Really, any team that would be willing to take on his contract. I don't care what we get for him, as long as a team takes upon that contract. And then we can get that extra $4 million from him. Sign a guy like Russell Okung. We can restructure some deals. We can possibly sign Allen Robinson to a long-term deal. So, you know, there are a ton of options for the Chicago Bears to go and sign, you know, some guys like this. Or, you know, if we were to trade Nick Foles to, like, a team like the Colts, Jags, or Jets, you know, we could possibly attach Nick Foles and maybe like a third or a second round pick, you know, but since they're giving up that high of a pick, you know, they would take on his contract, and maybe we can get like an offensive lineman from them, you know, an offensive lineman from the Jets or the Colts or the Jags. So that might be an option for what something that Ryan Pace can do, you know, a win-win, you know, a team gets Nick Foles, a good premier backup, and we get an offensive tackle who can be really, really good on this line. And that's about it, guys. I hope you really enjoyed this video. I hope I gave you a lot of information on the possible tackle options. And if you enjoyed it, guys, again, if you could do me a huge favor, it only takes less than 2 seconds and go and smash that like button. And if you go ahead, could subscribe if you loved what I had to offer in this video. That would mean a lot towards me. And if you're not watched all the way, go back and watch it all the way. And that would mean a lot towards me. Hit bell notifications. Comment, what do you think? Who should the Chicago Bears sign? Russell Okung, Michael Schwartz, you know, David DeCosto? Let me know in the comment section below. And yeah, with that all being said, everyone, peace out and bear down.